Why the hell not? So wish me luck. I don't know if you can actually tell, but Carter's just absolutely drenched. He literally got me right in the face of all the water. Also, didn't even last 10 minutes, it's gone. Hello, hope you've all had a good day. I only washed like an hour or so ago. I just feel like the day has gone really fast. I think probably because I've just finished doing all my Frankie's faves. There's gonna be quite a lot of info today, because I've done a mixture of clothes and like beauty products and things to kind of help you to feel good. So bear with me on that one and keep swiping. So I'll be doing Frankie's faves at 7, so in about half hour. And I'm hoping that you'll like it because it's taken me quite a while. I'm also going to put up my list of makeup products that I used in my silly makeup TikTok video, because so many of you have asked. Just to say, I really overdid the contour and everything on that. I would normally do it a little bit softer, but still really great products. So I will put up a picture of those and tag them all for you. So I'll see you at 7. So as part of Frankie's faves today, I kind of wanted to make it a little bit of a feel-good one. So I've included a couple little beauty regimes that I've been doing just to kind of make myself feel like my skin's keeping fresh. I suppose it'll be one nice thing to come out of this with. And just that makes me feel nice because, you know, I'm not someone that wears makeup every day. I'm certainly not someone that's going to be putting on any jeans or getting dressed in the day. So it's nice to feel like at least my face and my skin feel half decent. And then just a couple of things that have kind of helped with my mind in this lockdown. So here it goes. First of all, I've got my Jade face roller. I got mine from Free People because they were delivering. And it looks like this. I've had one for a while, my last one snapped somehow. So you use it to massage the face. I often use this one around my eyes and around here, you know, if you're feeling a bit puffy. And I did really notice a difference in my face. The main thing that I learned from Michaela actually was to put this in the freezer in like a sandwich bag to keep it clean. And when you've got a spot, often at night, I would just sit while I was watching Netflix or something and just go over and over where that spot was. And it would make the spot go down and the redness go down. And for me, that was a bit of a lifesaver before like any jobs that I had, any shoots that I had. And I got really into it because you can just sit and do it while you're watching TV. So that's a great one. Another thing that actually I've only really started using since we've been in lockdown is the Tan Luxe Super Glow. It's like a gradual self-tan. I'm always really funny about putting fake tan on my face just because I work so hard not to have spots. But a lot of friends have recommended this. And again, I asked Michaela before I started using it. She made me show her the texture of it. And it's really quite thin, like watery texture, so it doesn't feel like it's going to clog up your skin. I haven't noticed a smell with it, and I basically put this on before I put my moisturizer on, and I've not had any spots yet, and I think it just helps make you feel a little bit healthier, because obviously, I don't know, I'm not going out very much, so yeah, might make you feel a little bit nicer. One of my favourite luxuries at home, before even lockdown, is lighting a candle at night when the boys have gone to bed. And I'm one of those people, I'm really funny about scents and smells. They give me headaches, they make me feel sick, so I'm really picky, and I only ever really use one in our house. But I've recently found this one. It's called Calm from Marks and Spencer's, and it is just that. It smells like a spa, so it feels like a real luxury when you light it at night or when you're having a bath or even just in the house in the day. It just keeps everything smelling fresh. I've got like the oils and the sticks in my toilet, so it keeps them smelling nice and fresh. So I would definitely recommend it. It does just make you feel like, I don't know, you're in a calm and tranquil environment. Next up is a face mask, because everyone seems to love them. I love this skin brand. I've used quite a lot of their products and I've always been really happy with them. What I like about this face mask is that it's more targeted. So you put these little things anywhere you want them. So next to your eyes, if you're worried about wrinkles around your eyes, anywhere on your face really, under here, up here. You can put them on for 2 hours, or you can just chuck them on and keep them on overnight at the most. And that's why I quite like it, because sometimes your whole face doesn't need the same thing. You know, parts of your face, depends if you've got combination skin, need different things. I know for myself, some bits are a bit more oily than others. It's got hyaluronic acid and vitamin C in it, so it's really hydrating. So I would say that that's quite a good one if you're feeling a little bit tired and your skin isn't feeling that fresh. So if you follow me normally, you will know that I tend to not really wear makeup at home or on my days off. But the one thing I do, and the same on holiday, is my brows. I just don't feel done enough without them. I think they make such a difference. And especially once the rest of these eyelashes have come off, because they're already going, I'm going to need these bad boys even more. So I always use this Eyebrow Queen pencil. It's got a brush on the end and you don't have to sharpen it. It's a twisty one. It's like the perfect shape to be able to do your brows if you don't really necessarily know what you're doing. And if I really want my brows to last all day and I really want that like laminated look, this is perfect. It's the Eyebrow Queen Brow Fix. It is literally like glue. They do not move and you can really get that look where they're really brushed up. And then if I'm feeling a bit more lazy and I'm just at home and not bothered how long they last, I just use a clear brow gel. This one's from Anastasia, and I love it. It's literally just clear, wipe it on, it holds. And lastly, for those of you that do like to wear a little bit of makeup, like sometimes I have days where I'm feeling really rubbish and I think, you know what, I'm going to put a little bit of something on, but I don't want a really heavy face. So I've got this Bye Bye Under Eye by It, I think you pronounce it. It's got hyaluronic acid in it, hydrolyzed collagen, peptides, antioxidants. So I just put a little bit under my eyes. I'm quite lazy. I do tend to just use my fingers. It's quite thick, so you don't really need masses of it. I know Marlin, my makeup artist, is going to be watching this. Like, she's always telling me off that I'm too rough with my eyes. So that gives you a really good coverage. And then I've got this Terry CC cream. Then if you do want something just to kind of even out your skin tone, I've got this Bioterry CC cream. So I just put a little bit on my hand. I think this one's going to be a little bit too dark on me. It smells so nice and it just feels like moisturiser. Doesn't really feel like I'm putting anything on my skin. I'm so rough with my face. I mean, you could apply it, I'm being a bit extra and using a brush, but you can just apply it a bit like moisturiser. I might put a little bit of the cover up around my nose. And what I like about both products and why I use them is that they don't really feel like you've got anything on. They don't feel heavy, so I don't feel aware that I've got makeup on, which is like my biggest pet hate is I hate that feeling where you just feel like you just want to wash your face all day. And they've both got really good and nice ingredients in them, so I don't feel like they're going to make me break out. So there you go. You'll be pleased to know that that is the end of Frankie's faves today. I just really wanted to get in some nice little products that I like, that I think you'll like. So I hope you enjoyed it, a little bit different today. You just had to bear with me because literally before I went to post everything, Parker smashed a glass on the floor, so I had to clean that up. Wayne was cooking his little, doing his little chef thing and cooking dinner again. So he's stressed because he can't cope with the kids because they're always asking for something. And I wasn't being much help because I was trying to post this. And it was a bit of a long one. So I hope you like it. And let me know what you want for next week.
Damn, your girl so fine, but her breath is like, she says she wanna dance, but she don't know how to, I'm iced out, ooh, looking like a star, her name is Jenny, ooh, bitch don't have no panties, I'm Steph Curry, when I hit the,
wow, you can really dance, wow, you can really dance, he went, they said we've both been dancing all this time, what a coincidence.
So you back to I'm a savage, yeah. Classy, bougie, ratchet, yeah. Sassy, moody, hey. Nasty, hey. Yeah. Hacking, stupid, whoa. What's happening? Whoa. What was happening? Whoa. I'm a savage, yeah.
If you're supposed to put your contour on before the rest of your makeup or after the rest of your makeup, but it doesn't matter because men are stupid. So long as you look like a newborn baby, they are willing to mate with you. I'm poor, so I have this.
Noah is a safe fish.